Welcome to The Know. I'm Ashley Jenkins.
I'm Mika Burton.
In this age of broken releases and constant DLC, you have to ask yourself, do video games suck worse than ever? That is the headline being written, thanks to a study which supposedly shows that review scores have been steadily declining over the last 20 years.
This damning data comes courtesy of Finder.com, which has put together a chart of Metacritic scores spanning back two decades. And on the surface, some of their discoveries appear a bit startling.
Now we've got a discussion on our hands about whether or not games are getting worse or here's the other conclusion, if critical consensus is just getting harsher.
True, the internet does exist. So here's the information that Finder.com published. According to their data, a look at game scores from the last 20 years reveals a dramatic drop in games that averaged a 90 or above on Metacritic.
Finder took the Metacritic data all the way back to 1996, the year of our Lord's Diablo, Super Mario 64, Tomb Raider, and Resident Evil. I feel so old now. In 1996, there were only 9 titles to net a 90 or above on the review aggregator, but the situation quickly changed as we moved to the 2000s.
2000s, the year of Chrome and amazing movies on Disney Channel. So by 2000 and 2001, video games hit an all-time review score high with 28 and 32 games averaging more than 90 on Metacritic. That's a total of 60 games in 2 years. For a little bit of perspective, we've barely had more than 60 games receive a 90 in the last 5 years combined. Since 2011, we've had 61 total.
If you're wanting a little trip down memory lane, 2000 and 2001 saw the releases of games like Deus Ex, The Sims, Skies of Arcadia, Final Fantasy IX, Baldur's Gate 2, Unreal Tournament, Civilization 3, Majora's Mask, Black and White, Eco, Golden Sun, Twisted Metal Black, Final Fantasy X, Paper Mario, Halo, Gran Turismo 3, Metal Gear Solid 2, and Grand Theft Auto 3. That's where like all of my school money disappeared to, I guess.
God, that's...
What am I talking about? I was graduated by then. That's where like all of my full-time Ashley, you have to get a job money went to.
Those were also the years that the PS2 really came into its own, and they also saw the launch of the Xbox, the GameCube, which
yes.
brought some truly classic titles.
And handles.
Yes.
After 2001, things just haven't been the same. In fact, the number of games to average a 90 on Metacritic haven't risen above 23 since 2003, which was the year of Wind Waker, Splinter Cell, Prince of Persia, and Knights of the Old Republic.
Wind Waker. And the closest they've gotten to that number after that, it was in 2009 with 20 games scoring a 90 or above.
Yes, that the was golden age the of golden the last age. Generation.
That was the year of Arkham Asylum, Dragon Age Origins, Assassin's Creed 2, Uncharted 2, Minecraft, Street Fighter 4, Modern Warfare 2.
Now looking at the chart, it certainly looks, well, a little bit cyclical, and that makes sense, as the quality of games should expectedly rise and fall in time with new generations of consoles, since those are, well, a lot of the games that we're looking at here.
Yes.
The number of great games would seem to dip in a year that included new hardware and then rise over time as developers are able to settle into a generational groove, as it were.
But since 2009, that typical cycle seems to have changed, and the number of 90 or above games has drastically dipped. Titles averaging a 90 or more have gotten as low as hitting in the single digits in recent years, with 7 in 2014, 5 in 2015, and 8 in 2016. If that cyclical pattern held up, these should be the years that we're starting to see an uptick in very well-reviewed games.
Now, if you're wondering, the ones from 2016 included notable favorites like Uncharted 4, Inside, Overwatch, and Forza Horizon 3.
We've looked into these numbers a little bit ourselves in the past previous stories, but we've only gone back to the beginning of this decade, noting a similar trend in recent years.
However, coming to the conclusion automatically that this means games are getting worse is a little bit premature. There's quite a bit that this data doesn't account for, like, for example, the number of publications reviewing each of these games, or how many games are coming out in general, how many games are in the 75 to 90 range on Metacritic.
How many people are bitching online?
Yeah, exactly. Keep in mind that this is the rise of YouTube reviewers, smaller indie outlets, as it's become easier and easier and easier for individual people or small groups to create review sites on the internet, and they can all weigh in on Metacritic.
Exactly, and all of these pretty huge factors all tie together. With more outlets reviewing games than ever before, and more games coming out than ever before, one possibility is that rather than games getting worse, critical consensus is getting a bit tougher to achieve.
More critics are also being exposed to more games than ever before, meaning that the standard of a great game, which we would say would be 90 or above, is higher than it's ever been because you have so many other games to compare against.
In 1996's Mario 64, for instance, it only has 13 ratings on Metacritic, whereas 2016's Paper Mario Color Splash has 72.
That's a bit of a change.
That's a bit of a change. The explosion of enthusiast press and hobbyist blogs has led to more people reviewing games, which is going to dilute those scores somewhat.
And another factor tying into that would be the amount of games that sit just below 90 on Metacritic's scale. That number seems to be increasing year after year, according to some numbers we've gathered, which would mean that the bulk of games are getting better on average, but fewer reviewers are willing to give things a 9.
And that seems to be especially true on PC right now, which saw 46 games in the score range in 2016. PC exclusives like Civ 6, Owlboy, and Darkest Dungeon would fall in that category.
And I think we'd agree that those were all great games.
Very solid games!
But of course, there are loads of other considerations to be made here. We don't know how many titles were in that 75 to 90 range over the last 20 years, for instance, which could help to shed a little bit more light on the numbers.
And there are tons of other factors that could account for these scores as well. Are games releasing worse? There's definitely an argument to be had there, with more companies relying on patches and post-release content. Looking at you, No Man's Sky.
It's maybe 2017, but we haven't forgotten you. Potentially games are getting a little bit more homogenous thanks to rising budgets and publishers taking fewer chances than before as the industry matures and becomes bigger and bigger budget and they require millions and millions and millions of sales just to break even. There are going to be fewer risks, which is also why we have fewer new IPs and that sort of thing. I mean, that's another possibility. It could lead to review scores trending lower, at least on the very top end, as everything feels kind of more samey.
There's also the consideration that as hardware has evolved, it has become less likely that we'll see some of the leaps and bounds from a technical standpoint with video games, that we've reached a certain plateau, marking those really special groundbreaking titles, and they're farther and fewer between, just like going from triangle boobs of Tomb Raider to normal boobs of Tomb Raider. You don't really see that anymore.
Come on, we still like the triangle boobs.
They're top notch.
But the flip side of that argument is that as hardware and game development resources have improved, it should have paved the way for more opportunities, not fewer.
So really, there's not necessarily a clear answer for why things are trending the way they are. As most things go, the truth is probably somewhere in that murky middle. But what we do know is there's still lots of great games and a lot more of them releasing than we've ever had access to.
What kind of conclusion is that to draw? We need an absolute truth.
We need an opinion to go with.
What do you guys think of Finder.com's findings about the overall review scores of games? Let us know in the comments.
For future updates on video game reviews and salacious headlines, like this video and subscribe to The Know.
We're gonna need a real good headline for this one. Something sexy.
Video games.
Triangle boobs.
Triangle boobs. Triangle boobs are square boobs now? Are video games bad?
Triangle boobs deserve a 90?
Yeah!
Brownieville's, it's like brownie chips. Like, what's not to love?
So good.
So hard to resist though.